Hello, this is Blue Joe Saunders, WBO middleweight champion of the world. Subscribe to Sporting Icons to stay in touch with all the top news. God bless you all.
Hi everybody, hope you're all doing fantastic and enjoying your weekend. Well, in this video, I'm going to have a little bit of a rant. It's been overdue. I don't rant as much as I used to, but it's been overdue, especially on this particular subject. Now, Chris Eubank Jr. gets stopped by Liam Smith last night in Manchester. Big shot. He goes down, his legs are wobbled, tries to continue. He gets put down again, referee stops the fight, okay? Now, for many people, that was a shock. The fact that, not because Liam Smith won, but because he knocked out Chris Eubank Jr. So Chris Eubank Jr. now becomes part of a list of hundreds and hundreds, thousands of boxers who've been knocked out. And I'm seeing comments here on YouTube, across social media, Instagram, Twitter, which of course are the only two that I use. Not necessarily on my feeds, but I'm seeing people commenting in other people's videos when doing interviews with different fighters and different people. Chris Eubank Jr., his punch resistance is gone. Chris Eubank Jr. is shot. Chris Eubank Jr. should retire because he's never going to become world champion and all these other kind of things. A lot of people are suddenly neurologists, yeah? Talking about punch resistance. A lot of people are experts on body language, on psychology and all this kind of thing. And listen, maybe some people are, okay? So I'm not dismissing everybody, okay? But there's so many people sat there in their sofa saying that Chris Eubank Jr. should retire. Now, maybe he should, okay? I'm not here to say that you're right or wrong, okay? But only he knows that is the answer. So imagine if he listens to these people and retires. So whatever fight nights that may happen from now until the day he does actually retire, we don't get to watch. All the money that he's missed as well. Maybe Chris Eubank Jr. is going to go on to become a world champion. But give up all that because some people on the internet say you should retire. Your punch resistance is gone. You're shot. You're overrated. You never become a world champion. Other examples, look at, say, BJ Saunders. He gets stopped by Canelo Alvarez. His orbital bone gets broken. People call him a quitter. People say he's no good. His punch resistance is gone. He should retire. Why? Because he lost one fight? Well, maybe Billy Joe Saunders is going to come back and become world champion again and make a whole boatload of money and give us, boxing fans, more fight nights. But don't do all that. Stay there, raise your horses, and don't come back, Billy. That's what a lot of people are saying. Imagine if people like Daniel Dubois. Okay, he got stopped. His orbital bone got broken by Joe Joyce. He took a knee. I said it back then. I'll say it right now. It's the right thing to do. He preserved his career. Imagine if he listened to people retire. Quit. You're overrated. You're never going to become a world champion. Imagine if he'd listened. Right now, he wouldn't be sat there as WBA regular world heavyweight champion. As the mandatory challenger for the winner of Fury Usyk for big money. That wouldn't happen, would it? Anthony Joshua loses to Andy Ruiz Jr. in their first fight. He's shot, he's overrated, he's a hype job, he's chinny. Comes back, he beats Andy Ruiz Jr. They don't give him credit for it, they say he ran away. He loses twice to Alexander Usyk, where many people consider him a pound-for-pound superstar. The best that ever done it. He's about to go into a mega fight for Undisputed against Tyson Fury, where many people are picking Usyk to beat Tyson Fury. But Anthony Joshua loses to this guy, Anthony Joshua should retire. That means we don't get more fight nights with Anthony Joshua. Because some people say he'll never become world heavyweight champion again. Okay. Vladimir Klitschko, when he got stopped by, say, Corey Sanders and whatever else back in the day. Imagine all those people who said that he should quit, he should retire. Imagine if he did. He would never have made all the money that he made, all the fight nights that we got to watch and enjoy, and have a damn near 10-year reigning unified heavyweight world champion run, if he'd have listened. Imagine if Lennox Lewis, when he lost to either Oliver McCall or Haseem Rahman, if he'd just quit, retired, because he was chinny, he's never going to become a world champion again. He's never going to do anything. Imagine how he'd have done that. The fight nights that we would have missed out on. The fact that he retired as undisputed world champion wouldn't have happened if he'd have listened. We can go on and on and on. People lose. And for some reason, we seem to be entering a Floyd Mayweather era of, if you lose one fight, then you're shot. You're garbage. You're no good. You're never going to become world champion. Imagine if all the fighters currently, all the active professional fighters, male and female, who are never going to become world champion, just suddenly went, that's it, I'm done. I'm retired. Do you know how small the talent pool would be in boxing? Boxing would die overnight, wouldn't it? Because there wouldn't be enough talent to continue boxing. If everybody retired, what's going to happen with the loser of Tyson Fury, Alexander Usyk? There's going to be a lot of people out there saying that the loser of that fight is overrated. They're a bum. They're no good. Retire. Why? Because you lost one fight? Imagine if Tyson Fury had listened to all those people when he lost to John McDermott in the first fight. And he did lose. But, okay, he got a gift decision. He came back, he beat him. You saw how people's opinions on Tyson Fury, he's no good, he'll never amount to anything, he'll never become a world champion, he lost that fight, John McDermott got robbed, blah, 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 Tyson Fury should bugger off. Imagine had he listened. We would never have seen him fight in all the fights that we've seen him in, against Deontay Wilder, against Vladimir Klitschko, against Alexander Usyk. All the money that he's made, the fight nights that we've enjoyed. We wouldn't have got it all if he'd have listened to people. Derek Chisora should have retired years ago, say many people. Because suddenly they're worried about a man that they don't actually know about his future. Again, neurologist experts, right? No, maybe you're right. Maybe he's going to end up punch drunk at some point. Maybe. But all the fight nights that we've enjoyed with Derek Chisora, all the money, again, that he's made. Okay, it's not our business how much money these boxers make. It's not. But imagine if he'd have listened. All those fight nights that we've enjoyed with Derek Chisora, we wouldn't have got to see. Imagine if David Haye, when he took his first loss against Carl Thompson, imagine if he'd have stopped right there and then as well. He wouldn't have went on to become unified cruiserweight world champion, WBA heavyweight world champion, fight nights with Derek Chisora, fight nights with Tony Bellew, fight nights with Vladimir Klitschko, him going over and taking on Valuev, and all these kind of, it wouldn't have happened. If Tony Bellew had quit when he lost to Stevenson, when he got stopped by him, then we wouldn't have seen him at Everton Football Ground become WBC cruiserweight world champion, fight nights with Tony, with David Haye, and all these. You see, if all these fighters listen to the boxing fans who say, that's it, you've lost, that's it, you know, good, throw him on the scrap heap, the punch resistance is gone and all that kind of, what are you talking about? This is boxing. You get two people, man or woman, with two arms, two legs, punching each other. At some point, there's a very real chance you're going to get buzzed. You're going to get knocked out. You're going to get badly hurt. It's sport. Sport means sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Imagine if your football team that you support loses a football match. That's it, they're no good. Okay, let's just fold the club then, shall we? Because they lost to Brighton. Because they lost to Charlton. What? Okay, whatever. Your MMA or UFC fighters that you like, don't they take losses? But in boxing, it seems to be a different rule. If you take one loss, you're done, you're garbage, you're no good, you're overhyped, you're never going to become a world champion. You get knocked out, your punch resistance is gone and all that kind of stuff. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable. I said, some people may have some very valid points on it. You may well do. You may well do. But only the fighter knows. Only the fighter knows. And yes, of course, pride will get in the way of certain things. It will. And some fighters should retire. Okay? Some should. But if they all listened to boxing fans, myself included, if they all listened, boxing would be non-existent now, wouldn't it? So again, to go back onto Chris Eubank Jr., he should retire because he got knocked out by Liam Smith. Why? Is there something wrong with losing to Liam Smith? Is there something wrong with that? Is Liam Smith that bad and that embarrassing that Chris Eubank Jr. should just retire? Chris Eubank Jr. should have retired when he lost to BJ Saunders. What's wrong with losing to BJ Saunders? He should have retired when he lost to George Groves. What's wrong with losing to George Groves? Come on, people. Think about it. We can criticise, we can say whatever we like, and we're entitled to, okay? We're boxing fans, we buy the pay-per-views, we go to the shows, we do all that kind of stuff, okay? But let's not overreact to things. Let's not start becoming neurologists and psychologists and any other kind of ist. Because we're not. We can have an opinion, for sure. But to tell people when they're retired just because they've lost one fight, because Chris Eubank Jr. got knocked out for the first time in his career, he should just retire? Come on now. Drop your thoughts below. Click thumbs up, subscribe. Catch you next video.